Thank you. much this year. Did you hear that choir back there? Did you see the tree in the Grand Hotel? And I'm not positive, but I think I saw Santa back there.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Everywhere you go, take a look at the 5 and 10, glistening once again with candy canes and silver lanes aglow. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Toys in every store. And a pistol that shoots is the wish of Barney and Ben. Dolls that will talk and will go for a walk is the hope of Janice and Jen. And Molly and Jack and Harvey wait for school to start again. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Soon the bells will start and the thing that will make them ring is the carol that you
right within your heart,
right within your heart.
It's the most wonderful time. the Savior of the world. And we're going to all stand and rise and worship him tonight as we all sing joy to the world. The Lord has come. Let's all sing together in one voice. Let's worship him tonight. Come on, let's sing.
Joy to the world.
Tonight, because they got to see something very special. So we're going to sing about that. Hark the herald angels sing, and glory to the newborn king. If you're excited about that, let's worship tonight. Come on, sing it.
Hark the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn king. Peace on earth and mercy mild, God. Rise, join the triumph of the skies with angelic hosts.
Fox News. Sing it out.
King of heaven, come down. King of heaven, come down. Let your glory reign, shining like the day. King of heaven,
welcome your presence here tonight. Lord, we love you and we give you all the praises and all the glory, for you're so worthy of it all. Lord, we pray as we continue to worship you tonight that all creation sings, everyone bows down in awe of your presence. We love you, Lord Jesus. We are thankful for the birth of you coming here and that you are here with us right now. Father, be with us as we worship you, give you all the praises and all the glory. Let's sing it out to him tonight, folks. Angels.
Song. Oh, oh, oh.
tonight, right? Hey, it's Christmas. Come on.
Yeah, let's put our hands together. I love it.
Woo!
All right, come on. Let's sing it.
Come to Bethlehem and see.
Gathered here to worship our Lord Jesus Christ. All the angels sing him. All creation will sing. All the people will sing. Let's sing this.
The angels sing. Creation sings. Your people sing. We sing Gloria. The angels sing.
Christmas, and Baptists can have a little bit of fun, right? Can I hear an amen to that? All right, all right. What we're going to do is our friend Deborah here is going to start us off. So let her go, and then we're going to echo what she does.
In excelsis Deo.
In excelsis Deo.
Said, amen. You may be seated and watch this video. Thank you.
The spirit of Christmas invites us in to be open enough to feel what we otherwise ignore. To be generous enough to give what we otherwise would claim to. To be childlike enough to believe what we otherwise brush off. And to see what we otherwise miss. Seeing is possible, but only in the presence of light. Because without light, we're forced to squint and strain, struggling to understand a world that feels like a shapeless, colorless expanse. But we're not made for the darkness. So God, with the mighty power of just his voice, thrust into motion an explosive, wild, beautiful act of creation. In that moment, God began a motion that would show us his love for all eternity. As God continued to speak his imagination into life, with one act of creation more extraordinary than the last, he formed a world teeming with beauty, peace, order, harmony, a simple, easy rhythm as creation lived together with its creator. Pride got the best of us. With a single act of rebellion, we opened up a door for chaos, darkness, fear. It would be generations before God would send another kind of light to chase darkness away once and for all. God had taken away a fray of our humanity to save us from ourselves. It had been prophesied many hundreds of years that there would be an end, declaring that there would be an end to the darkness. For it was a desolate time for the people of Israel. The cruel reign of Herod the Great had left them dejected and downcast. Enduring wars, political strife, and the onslaught of pagan religions, the chosen people of God began to place their last hopes in the promised coming of the Messiah. The heavens seemingly sat still as the mighty army of angels hovered in place, waiting for God to set in motion the events that would bring forth the new covenant, God's promise to reconcile all people from their sins through the blood of his only son, Jesus Christ. And so the angels hushed in anticipation as they watched Gabriel descend to the Virgin Mary. Mary embraced the news of the angel and submitted herself as a servant of the Lord. Together with her betrothed husband, Joseph, she made the journey to the crowded city of Bethlehem, where the only shelter they could find was in a stable on the outskirts of town. In the fullness of time, Mary gave birth to Jesus and laid him in the manger. Heavens were silent no more as the call rang out for the angels to assemble.
Hear me now, O heavenly host, great news of joy I bring. On this night upon the earth, the High Prince of Heaven has been born. He has gone to dwell among the children.
By the multitude of angels singing, "Glory to God in the highest," the shepherds made their long journey to see the promised newborn king. They went by faith, trusting in God's promise.
Thank you.
In a singular birth of a baby, God's own son would divide history into two. The birth of Jesus meant an end to darkness. Look around. Christmas is almost here. Can you feel it? The anticipation is building like a low, gentle hum, constant and steady. God's children waited and waited for salvation to finally arrive, like a flicker of hope in the sky. So, we wait. As the hum builds, pulsing with our hopeful expectation until finally, with the pounding of our own hearts, we welcome the celebration of a man. God with us. We look around to find something that we can give as part of this celebration. But we find nothing. Nothing that is adequate enough in comparison to the giving of this newborn king. But the greatest gift any of us can bring is our heart. Our heart to worship. Worship him. So we come today on this silent night to worship. Worship this newborn king. Bring our gifts to him, whatever they may be. To worship, and you will see that Christ loves you and me.
To breathe.
child is born. He shall reign forevermore. No.
Yeah. Did you know that your baby boy will one day walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will save our sons and daughters? Did you
one with the Holy Spirit and with the Father.
We lift our songs of praise to thee.
Redeeming love has set us free.
God bless you. Praise the Lord on high. Let's all stand to our feet and let's sing one more time. Joy to the world. The Lord has come. Let's sing our praises in all one voice and worship him tonight.
Joy to the world. The Lord is come. Let
the Merry Christmas. Thank you for joining us. God bless you on your safe travels home. God bless you. Thank you so much.